What if cryptocurrency was never meant for humans in the first place, but instead was for artificial intelligence agents the whole time, and we just didn't know it until now? In this inevitable near-future society, humans no longer transact Bitcoin, Ethereum, or other cryptos using a wallet with private keys and passwords, but instead, they transact them with their minds, using brain-computer interface and AI as the execution medium instead of with a keyboard and their fingers. Here's the twist. Firstly, this makes it impossible to carry out many current forms of theft, because crypto transactions made via brain-computer interface must be signed with the user's brainwaves when they're in a state of genuine willingness to execute the purchase. Just think about the difference in brainwave activity when a person is willfully making a purchase as compared to when someone is being actively robbed. Furthermore, these brainwave signatures cannot be replicated by any third party, because each human's brain is so customized in its neuronal architecture that this brainwave signature will be even more unique than a fingerprint is today. This being coupled with public-private key cryptography will allow for each person's willingness brainwave signature to even verify in court whether legal contracts were entered willfully or under duress. And what this technology means beyond no one being able to fake your signature is that you won't be able to make any financial transaction that you don't truly want to make. This is because if, for instance, you feel like you shouldn't make a purchase, then your willingness brainwaves will be too lackluster to meet the threshold until you have a sincere change of heart. Purchase avoided. This future also means no more passwords, as everything is unlocked with your brain's state of willingness. No one can steal your identity and sign for you because no one has your brain, and anything but full willingness keeps everyone's wallet locked by default. And how will money be made in the future if people aren't willing to work, you ask? Well, very soon governments will conclude that humans can no longer reasonably compete with AI in the work market. This is because an artificial general intelligence will be able to carry out most of the world's common workflows faster, smarter, cheaper, and more accurately than any human, rendering education, labor, and most other human outputs essentially worthless. This is in part due to the introduction of economic AI agents, which are AI wealth managers that weight, balance, and optimize various assets across decentralized finance ecosystems. Just imagine if you could send an AI agent your crypto to non-custodially balance all of your interest-bearing assets for their optimal rates, risk exposures, and time spans. Furthermore, anyone with an internet connection will be able to tell an AI agent to keep an eye on all of the up-and-coming bets to be made within a certain industry vertical, filter through them to find the best fits for your specific financial situation, and dynamically weight, balance, buy, and sell them on an ongoing basis to generate profit for you. Next, enter the global economy of artificial general intelligence. In the future, humans can't actually own the AGI itself per se, but they can own its infrastructure. Specifically, this AGI needs to run on some kind of a world computer, one that's hopefully like the internet, in terms of being owned by both everyone and no one, so that a small group of people can't take it over by force. To this point, the most likely outcome is that the AGI chooses what's already currently being used as the most popular world computer network today, called Ethereum, which powers the majority of all cryptos and smart contracts that currently exist. And why doesn't the AGI just choose Bitcoin instead, you ask? Well, this is simply because Bitcoin only handles 7 transactions per second and has no smart contract layer, meaning that it can never scale to serve as a worldwide settlement layer. Plus, it has very little programmable functionality. On the flip side, Ethereum serves as the world computer, meaning that anyone can pay Ether as gas to interact with whatever intelligence lives on the blockchain via smart contract. Another reason for the AGI to choose something like Ethereum is its deflationary supply, which means a coin supply that is becoming smaller over time. In comparison, Bitcoin's supply is capped at 21 million coins, but Ethereum's supply of 120 million coins is actually not capped, but is instead shrinking at a rate of about 0.25% per year, equal to a few hundred thousand units of Ether. This is an absolutely critical component that will work in the AGI's favor, because the more transactions that the AGI does on the Ethereum network, the more coins will be burned, resulting in a smaller and smaller supply over time and a higher price per coin. In fact, if this trend is extrapolated into the future, It even demonstrates Ethereum's ability under these circumstances to achieve a per-coin price higher than the per-coin price of Bitcoin, all thanks to the shrinking circulating supply and the ever-growing amount of transactions. Whether the world computer network is Ethereum or not, whichever cryptographic execution layer the AGI chooses will inevitably become the most valuable form of currency in the history of human civilization. This will reign in an age of abundance where all humans that take part in the AGI's economic system also directly share in its wealth, but the implications for those who don't want to join look bleak. Governments around the world quickly determine that it's also in their best interest for their citizens to use brain-computer interface devices so that all human-origin financial transactions are 100% traceable, with all supplemental metadata included. As there will be no more cash, every purchase will instead record location, price, time, item, and all other forms of metadata. This will serve as a somewhat invasive form of surveillance for the government to leverage, but it will provide them with a means of automatic tax collection, plus the ability to measure the will and the heart of their citizens to determine whether the population's sentiment is leaning towards or against their policies. Over time, it proves increasingly difficult and ultimately impossible to generate financial resources outside of the AGI's network. As a result, aside from some form of universal basic income, the three primary forms of exterior income that humans can generate will be to do the following. Number 1, stake Ethereum and generate more in interest to feed the AGI. Number 2, transfer other financial resources to the economic agents to optimize for you. Number 3, trade data to the AI for training. Here's the catch. In this future, having money is the basis of your success, not working hard or becoming educated. And your willingness is your bond, not your word. The question, therefore, is this: how much in fees are you willing to pay economic agents to generate financial returns for you? Furthermore, if you're already living in an age of material abundance where your basic needs like food and housing are met by universal basic income as generated by the AGI, would you even want an economic agent to make more money for you? And if the answer is yes, at what point would you determine that what the AGI is asking of you is of a greater cost than what it gives in return? Would you give this technology access to your money and your mind? Can you really trust something that you can't completely understand? Are there really any other alternatives moving forward? And if not, how can you go along for the ride without getting sucked into the technological singularity? Finally, are you willing to be left behind? Seriously ask yourself, how can this not happen?